Hello, my name is James Allen Polly Barker, and I'm the current chapter president of Phi Theta Kappa, Alpha Omega Gamma chapter at Ashland Community and Technical College. Phi Theta Kappa is a prestigious honor society for two-year colleges with a mission to recognize academic achievement of college students and provide opportunities to grow as scholars and leaders. Phi Theta Kappa offers a variety of opportunities for students to get involved in their community. One of these opportunities is an initiative called Honors in Action, a project that involves academic research, problem solving, and action-oriented service, following different research themes provided by Phi Theta Kappa. This year, the ACTC chapter chose the theme Expressions of Truth and centered our Honors in Action project around the perceptions of country music Highway 23, a path of prominent music artists running throughout eastern Kentucky and through many of our hometowns. We wanted to examine what people from our area knew about country music Highway 23 and how music and the arts defines the culture of eastern Kentucky and the Appalachian. As a part of our action component, we wanted to create a video presentation that can be widely distributed to share the results of our research. We have many exciting things to share with you, one of which being a special resource we found within our own organization through our research. I'd like to introduce Julie Reeves Davis, a seasoned country music singer and former host of the Dog Radio Station. We stumbled onto a New York Times article interviewing Julie for a story on Country Music Highway 23 through our research, and discovered she is now a current student at Ashland Community and Technical College and a member of our Phi Theta Kappa organization. She's agreed to share with us some of her experiences as a music artist and why our arts and music heritage is the heart of our culture in Eastern Kentucky.
My name is Julie Reeves Davis, and I'm a student at Ashland Community and Technical College, and I'm currently in the Surgical Technology Program and a member of Phi Theta Kappa. Well, I've loved music since the day I was born, really. I loved to sing since I was a little girl. I was probably 6 years old when I first sang in front of an audience, which was in church, and I sang Jesus Loves Me. And of course, you know, you get all the applause and you think, I really like this. So I wanted to just sing every day. I would rather be in my room singing in whatever I could find to use as a microphone than to be out playing with my friends. And as soon as I graduated from school, I moved to Nashville. I was 19 years old, moved to Nashville, and I actually signed a record deal with Capitol Records in 1996 and released an album in 1999, writing songs and making music and singing for a lot of songwriters, making demos, and I had my daughter and wanted to raise her where I grew up. So I moved back to Kentucky, where I was born and raised, and I've been here ever since. Country Music Highway represents all the amazing, you know, iconic country artists that come from this area. I think it's great to let people know, you know, hey, we have a lot of talented people here and big stars that have come from this area. A lot of those inspired me and let me know that I could live out my dream. And I feel like, you know, having that recognition, you know, helps people see that they can live out their dream too, being from right here in Kentucky. A lot of the sound in country music really started right here in Kentucky. It comes from a lot of emotion from people who, you know, first came here and had to go through a lot of hard things. You know, a lot of people who aren't from here wouldn't really know that there's such a rich heritage here with music and the arts. There's so much of the sounds of country and the sounds of, you know, bluegrass music, folk music, and all of that that originated right here from some of our early settlers. And, you know, kind of, if you listen to some of the older, more traditional songs, you get a glimpse of what life was like. You hear that soul and that pain that they felt, and or even the joy, and just how they got through, how they used music just in everyday life. And they would eat supper and go out on the porch, and they would pick and sing. You know, they would play instruments and they would sing and they would write songs on the spot. They would, you know, sing from their heart, and you would get a glimpse of their real life. I just think it's so important for people to see just how powerful music is, really. I mean, when you think about just the history of it, it's just so important, I feel like, for people to know just Kentucky's heritage and Kentucky's roots in that, in the arts. And I'm so glad to be from here and to have experienced some of that and to be part of it.
Hello, my name is Tanner Dickerson, and I'm the current treasurer for Phi Theta Kappa chapter of Ashland Community and Technical College. One of the biggest aspects of our Honors in Action project was research. To find out more about the perceptions of Country Music Highway 23, we drafted a survey that was administered to ACTC students, faculty, staff, and community members. Some of the questions on our survey asked people to share their comments on what they think Country Music Highway 23 is. A list of several prominent musicians to check off which ones they knew about, different genres of music they may listen to outside of country music, and comments on how music affected their daily life. We gathered surveys from 200 people and discovered the following results. Those included were that it was a famous highway in eastern Kentucky, and is a recognition of country and bluegrass music singers throughout eastern Kentucky. The top three recognized artists from Country Music Highway 23 includes: number one, Billy Ray Cyrus from Flatwoods, Kentucky, and is known for his song Achy Breaky Heart. At number two, Loretta Lynn, who is from Butcher Hollow, Kentucky, and is known for her song Coal Miner's Daughter. And at number three, Chris Stapleton, who was born in Lexington, Kentucky, and grew up in Paintsville, is also known for his song Tennessee Whiskey. We also wanted to share more information about some of the artists that may not be as familiar to us but are from eastern Kentucky, including Tom T. Hall. He was from Allfield, Kentucky. He was nicknamed Storyteller because he was able to connect with so many people through his songs in the area where he was raised in. And lastly, Dwight Yoakam. He was from Pikeville, Kentucky. He was an actor and a musician, and is recognized as a new traditionalist artist, which during that time was part of the alternative country movement. Top three music styles selected as most listened to by our survey participants included: at number one was country music, at number two, pop music, and lastly at number three, classic rock. Lastly, some of the comments on how music affects people's life included: they listen to it on their daily commutes, it's a way for them to escape and relax, and it helps calm their nerves. We got great feedback through our survey research and insight that music is much more than a passive activity. It is integrated in crucial aspects of our lives. The artists of Country Music Highway 23 and their expressions of truth make an enormous impact on helping us escape our troubles and enrich our day-to-day routines.
Hello, my name is Shemae White, and I am the current Vice President of the College Project and Services for ACTC's Phi Theta Kappa chapter. When we decided to choose the topic of Country Music Highway 23 for our Honors in Action project, we had several options on local heritage sites to visit in aid of our research. We wanted to get some hands-on experience for our research on top of what we could find in books and articles. Our first stop was to visit the Highlands Museum, located in downtown Ashland, Kentucky. The Highlands Museum has a long-standing history of educating people of all ages about the history of the Ashland area and hosts one of the best displays of the artists and heritage of Country Music Highway 23. During our visit to the Highlands Museum, we were able to get the specialized tour and learn more about the country music artists of Eastern Kentucky through the museum's interactive exhibit. Another stop for our group was the US 23 Country Music Highway, located in Staffordsville, Kentucky. The museum offers a renowned and ample collection of memorabilia of all the music artists who are from Highway 23. The Highway 23 Museum is located near Butcher Holler, Kentucky, where we also made a visit to Loretta Lynn's home place and Webb's Grocery. Touring Loretta Lynn's home place cabin was an amazing experience. You get to go back to an older time and relive the ways of the Appalachian mountain folk trying to make a living the best way they can by working the land, working in the coal mines, keeping a home, and raising a family. Loretta Lynn is of the most important artists in the entire history of country music and is right from our home in Eastern Kentucky. She is a testament that dreams can come true and you never have to forget where you came from. Her music and that of all the others on Country Music Highway 23 expresses a form of truth that highlights the theme and purpose of the Honors in Action project for Phi Theta Kappa. We should never underestimate the power of music, artists, and storytelling, and the enrichment it brings to our daily lives, along with the preservation of our cultural heritage. In conclusion, I'd like to encourage all of you watching to make time to visit some of these heritage sites we shared with you that was part of our research journey. These local places are inspiring, educational, and an important testament to the culture of Appalachia. Visiting these sites for our research was among some of the best experiences we could have for our Phi Theta Kappa Honors in Action project.
Hello, my name is Andrew Miller, and I'm the current secretary of our Phi Theta Kappa chapter at Ashland Community and Technical College. One of the most important aspects of our Honors in Action project was research. We were lucky in that our ACTC library was able to provide all of our resources for free and online, which made it easier for us to stay involved in the research process while safe at home during COVID-19. The importance of libraries cannot be understated, even if you aren't actively involved in a research project. Some of the resources we reviewed included the Encyclopedia of American Folklife, a wide variety source exploring rich and varied cultural traditions on folklife throughout America with more than 350 entries. Another great source was a book called Heartaches by Number. This source covered pioneering music videos, a definition of country music, and a review of over 1,200 songs, covering 9 decades of artistry and history. Lastly, another great resource is one that is readily available to all of you, the website Kentucky Country Music. Here you can find the stories on the stars of country music, Highway 23, and the collectors, promoters, and entrepreneurs who have worked behind the scenes to bring country music to national attention. From my own personal perspective, the Honors in Action Research Project gave me a wealth of knowledge as a Florida native who is not from Eastern Kentucky. I've been a lifetime country music fan, and through these different research sources, I found out things I never knew about many of my favorite country songs and artists. Our research on the Country Music Highway 23 artists inspired us to create a visual display called The Songs of Highway 23. Designing posters on 11 of the prominent artists and highlighting one of their famous songs. Our displays will reside at the library at both College Drive and Technology Drive campuses at ACTC. We encourage everyone in our community to stop by and visit our displays during library operating hours. We decided to make this display to give back to our community, educate on our prominent and local music artists, and promote appreciation for enrichment for the arts, music, and culture of Eastern Kentucky.
As our presentation concludes, on behalf of Pi Theta Kappa and ACTC, we'd like to thank you for watching and learning about our Honors in Action project. We hope this has inspired you to learn more about Country Music Highway 23 and to visit some of the local heritage sites and museums and to check out what literature and other resources you can find at your local library. Please consider stopping by the library at either College Drive or Technology Drive campuses to check out our visual display on the songs of Highway 23. To finish up, we're now going to hear a song from Julia Reeves Davis. We hope to see you on one of our ACTC campuses soon.
so sad and dead blue. I was thinking about you.
Filled with you.